We have more in-depth coverage now on the Ebola outbreak and its impact on some residents here. As we've been reporting, Rhode Island has a very large Liberian population, and now we've learned a local effort is hoping to provide loved ones there with some basic necessities. Eyewitness News reporter Madeline Wright joins us now live with more on that. Madeline.
Mike, there are a lot of people out there working to control the Ebola crisis. The United States is sending thousands of soldiers. Humanitarian groups are sending doctors and nurses. But for those of us who don't have those kinds of resources, one local church group has found a simple way to help.
As the Ebola outbreak ravages Liberia, a food shortage is also taking a toll.
Many people were going hungry because they couldn't work, they're limited to how far they can travel.
Reverend Dr. Don Anderson with the Rhode Island State Council of Churches says he and others are trying to help by raising money for a church in Liberia called Generations for Christ Mission Church.
They agreed that if we sent them money, they would buy food in bulk, and then they would distribute that food to other congregations, and that food then would be distributed out among the churches and the people there in the suburbs and into Monrovia.
Anderson says if people have enough to eat, their immune systems will be stronger. The CDC released a report last month saying the number of Ebola cases in Liberia doubles every 15 to 20 days.
This is really a very scary outbreak. One of the pastors that we know has lost four people in his family. This is a tragedy that is thousands of miles away, but has an impact right here in Rhode Island.
Anderson says the church in Liberia is promising to use all the donations for food.
$40 buys a 100-pound bag of rice, and that rice will go a long way.
And he says the church will send letters, pictures, and videos as confirmation they're using the money the way it's intended.
Anderson says sending money for food is a quick way to make an immediate impact on the people who live in Liberia. He says they've already raised $1,500 and they're planning to send their first payment tomorrow. Live with the Mobile Newsroom, Madeline Wright, Eyewitness News.
And count on Eyewitness News for continuing coverage of the Ebola outbreak. You can check out WPRI.com for extended coverage, including vital information about the disease and a timeline tracking past Ebola outbreaks.